Welcome to our Easter Day celebration here in Three Cliffs Parish. Today we give thanks for in dying Christ has conquered death. In rising to life again, he has opened to us the way to everlasting life. He has been raised from the dead, and indeed he has gone ahead of us. Hallelujah. As we meet in the love and light of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, let us rejoice in the power of the resurrection. For hallelujah, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. The Lord is here and his Spirit is with us. Blessed are you, the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. To you be the glory and praise forever. By raising your Son from the dead, death has been destroyed and new life has been restored. In him the victory over sin and the grave is won. May we live as Easter people, reflecting the glory of your resurrection. Blessed are you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. This morning, our reading comes from Matthew's Gospel. Now, after the first day of the week began to dawn, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat on it. His countenance was like lightning, his clothing as white as snow, and the guard shook for fear for him and became like dead men. But the angel answered and said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. For he has risen, as he said, come, see the place where the Lord lay. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead, and indeed he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." And so they went out and quickly ran from the tomb with fear and great joy, and ran to bring his disciples word. This is the Easter Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I have read those words this morning from the Bible that Andrea gave me when I was in college. And in the front of this, my wife wrote, "Christmas 1998. May the Lord bless and keep you always." And that, in a sense, is our message for today. May the Lord bless and keep us always. And in the Bible, next to that passage, I wrote these notes. Love is everything. It enables us to put aside our differences. It enables us to move beyond being a term, custard Christians, that gets upset over trifles. Love brings revival. Love brings us together. And we become before God because of this first Easter, where the grave clothes were to one side and neatly folded, where the light shone out of the tomb, where the angel made that appearance. We become a praying, loving, and willing church. And Jesus met the women as they ran from the tomb. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them saying, "Rejoice." So they came and held him by the feet and worshipped him. And Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brethren to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." Today that same Jesus says to us, "Rejoice, go and tell." This is God's church. We celebrate this special day. Now rejoice together. Go and tell. Amen. Let us pray. Risen Lord, we remember all who walk in darkness and all who are burdened with troubles, the heavy-hearted and the sad. We ask your blessing upon all who are separated from their loved ones and who feel lonely or lost. We bring before you all who are ill, especially from COVID-19. all who are fearful, and all who will die this day. We ask you to comfort all who stand by a graveside weeping, and all who will mourn, yet your message of eternal life breaks into that mourning and that darkness, and makes your presence of light, love, and life known. Listen, Lord, we ask that we indeed might share in your resurrection and triumph over darkness and death. We ask your blessing upon our friends and loved ones and the departed. May they know of your power in the fullness of your kingdom. This day we rejoice that death is conquered. We are free, for you have won the victory. Risen Lord, make your presence known. And so we commend this day to God with the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be this thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Christ, you are risen from the dead, and we are risen with you. May our life never deny this eternal joy, this peace and hope and joy. Praise and glory to the God of life, who is stronger than all kinds of death. Hallelujah, we are an Easter people, and hallelujah is our song.
See you.
Song of joy, a loud celebration shout on this glorious Easter day. No love is indeed higher, nor love is indeed wider, nor love is indeed greater than Christ's love for you and me. So shout for joy, there is love, vast as an ocean. Hallelujah, he is risen.